Welcome to Asia. Number 1. Contributions of Asians to the world, such as talents and skills. The Hindu-Arabic numerals. These are the numbers we are using today. Originating from India in the 6th or 7th centuries, the writings of the Middle East mathematicians, especially Al-Khwarizmi and Al-Kindi, were introduced to Europe around the 12th century. They were a profound break from earlier counting methods such as the abacus and paved the way for algebra development. Algebra. The most important Arabic mathematician, Muhammad ibn Musa al-Khwarizmi, is known to date as the father of algebra. Algebra is the branch of mathematics in which abstract symbols rather than specific numbers are applied to arithmetical operations and formal manipulations. Nowadays, it is being taught in secondary and tertiary levels around the world. Cuneiform writing. Cuneiform is the oldest writing system known in world history. It originated in Mesopotamia civilization. The cuneiform was used for writing about 15 different languages, including Sumerian, Akkadian, Babylonian, Syrian, Elamite, Hittite, Urartian, and Old Persian. Technological skills. Nowadays, we can see the growth of some Asian countries through technology. China, Japan, Korea, and Singapore have major technological advancements throughout the years, such as flagship phones, fastest mobile internet, modern appliances, and environmental-friendly technologies that attributes to globalization. Medicine. Traditional Asian medicines include leaves, branches, seeds, and fruits which are manufactured into teas. Acupuncture and other herbal medicines in China dates back at least 2,200 years ago, which in turn one of the oldest medical systems in the world. It was then introduced to other countries in the 19th and 20th century. Number 2. Contributions of Asians to the West. Asia's made the following special contributions to the West. First, the Asian colonies supplied the much-needed raw materials so they expand their economy, grow richer and powerful to factories in Britain, France, America, and other Western powers. Second, for the manufactured product of their colonial oversights, Asian colonies served as lucrative markets. Western clothes, Western food, Western drinks, Western smoked cigarettes, drive cars, Western sports and play games, and watch movies have all the subjected Asians learned to speak. Therefore, they were made good customers of Western products. Third, Western fortune hunters have secured fabulous gems, rare ceramics, delicious tapestries, and other valuable art treasures from the temples, places, and privately held collections of Asian art. The pride and glory of museums, art galleries, and royal collections in the West are now Asian art treasures. Fourth, the Asian colonies provided the labor and natural resources of their colonial masters to win the World War I and World War II. For instance, in 1941-45, the Philippines battled Japan bravely and helped bring the United States and allies to their ultimate victory. Finally, Western nations gained considerable prestige in the world affairs by acquiring rich colonies in Asia. The Spanish king boasted that the sun never set on his empire when he held settlements in Asia, Africa, and South America. The United States gained world recognition from the Philippines and Guam in 1898. England, a small island nation, became by a far-flung colonies the largest power in the world in the 19th century. Number 3. Contributions of Western powers to Asia. Asian culture, policy, economy, and science have always been altered by Western power. Regardless of how resentful the Western presence was, the Asians have gained in the following ways a new material and better way of life. First, the West brought the machinery and technical skills that transformed Asian economies into the Industrial Revolution technology. New industries have been created for feudal and homemade farming. In towns and villages, the industrial cities and lively factories emerged. Railways, steamships, airlines, telegraphs and telephones, paved roads and passageways, radio and television stations came along. Second, in Asian countries, Western missionaries have reinstated Christianity. In contemporary times, Western missionaries spread Christianity, which was founded on Asian territory, which is Palestine, by an Asian, Jesus Christ. Today, the Philippines is a continuous monument of missionaries' achievements as the greatest Christian nation in Asia and heir to a missionary mantle. Third, Western imperialism brought new arts and sciences, popular education, the Western calendar, alphabet, among others. Fourth, the West has removed a number of pernicious customs and practice in Asia, like the caste system, burning a widow or sati, the tugi, or the strangulation of human sacrifices in India. Women wear a veil and isolation in Islamic countries, slavery, childhood brides, human victims, and other customs. Finally, Western ideas of nationalism, finally replacing the outmoded Oriental despotism, republics, confined monarchy, democracy, and communism in Asia. The United States brought Philippines democracy. It is brought to Malaysia, Singapore, Hong Kong, India, Pakistan, and Sri Lanka by the Britons. Russia introduced communism in China, North Korea, Mongolia, and Indochina. Westerners also brought to Asia nationalism and independent political doctrines that ironically inspired Asians to overthrow Western colonialism.